फास्टेस्ट क्रिकेट स्कोर अपडेट्स या सबसे डिटेल्ड स्टैट्स,
क्रिकेट के अंदर बाहर की खबरें
या हेल्दी डिबेट्स,
सबसे एक्यूरेट एनालिसिस
या फैंस का क्रेज,
सबके लिए एक ही प्लेटफॉर्म,
क्योंकि क्रिकेट मतलब क्रिकेट नेक्स्ट।
It's a heartbreak for RCB fans as they finally crashed out of the IPL 2024 after winning 6 matches on the trot, playing against a team that was completely out of form. The team that had lost 4 matches in a row and had the last match washed out under rains. But today, RR was the better team as they defeated RCB by 4 wickets and have booked their place in qualifier 2. I have with me Soumya Kapoor. Hello, Soumya. What do you think of the game today? Where do you think RCB lost it?
Everywhere, I guess they lost from the word go. I was not really satisfied the way Faf and Kohli had started off the innings. Yeah, people would say, you know, they were looking good, they were playing an aggressive brand of cricket, but you know that isn't always required, and that's what happened. You know, when Uzi dismissed, as we can see, Virat, that was the same slog sweep that he has been playing in this later half of the stage of this IPL. And that cost his wicket. And, you know, a set Virat Kohli can give you, what, 70, 80 more runs, not just 30, 40. You know, double to any of the batters. So, if Virat would have played till the end, it could have been a very different ball game altogether, because obviously RCB needed some 20, 30 more to add on to that total, and they were surely, well and truly into that game. But again, you know, there are pundits, there are experts who just talk about the intent. And a lot more things, you know, intent आपको तब काम आता है जब आप 50, probably जब वो सब तब काम आता है जब आप 50 बॉल 90 करके जाओ,
right?
आप अगर 10 बॉल में 20 करके जा रहे हो, then it's of no use, and this is what exactly happened today. The strike rate of Virat Kohli, Faf du Plessis, you know, even Cameron Green, as we can see, that wasn't really up to the mark, and I am not really understanding why Suresh Prabhudasai is benched. I mean, I understand the obsession, the price tag that comes in with Glenn Maxwell, but there is no, you know, वो एक जबरदस्ती आप एक player को fit in करना चाहते हो 11 के अंदर. I don't understand this. Probably have him in the fag end of the batting, you know, batting innings ना, जब आप उसको एक license दे सकते हो. Maxwell in that middle over phase when you were 4-3-4 down, I'm not understanding what his role was, and there that's where RCB have again, you know, lost the plot. Suresh Prabhudasai should have come in. You can well and truly use that impact player rule. You didn't use that, you know. And Maxwell didn't even come to bowl. He was out for a first ball duck. He didn't. He was really bad in the field as well. He dropped one catch as well. So yeah, a proper off day at the office. You know, not taking anything away. From what Maxwell brings to the table, but he's bringing absolutely nothing to the RCB table. That is it.
Exactly. He has not brought anything throughout the season as such. Yeah. But I'd want to dwell a bit deeper into what you told about strike rates and Kohli's winning. So, two, 4 days pehle, I was going through one Kohli's interview, and he said that he's able to play fast in the power play, is able to play at a strike rate of 160, 180 or say 200 sometimes in the power play, because he knows that there is betting till number 8. Even if they lose 5 or 6 wickets early, they can use the impact player thing and have another batter coming in. So that is why he tries to go hard after the bowlers, at least in the power play. So do you think and also what happened yesterday, the scorecards like this are the days when I feel that there is too much of talk about strike rate and there is no need of anchor in T20s. But then you see scorecards like this and you feel that 20 runs more from here on, someone sticking on the crease for a bit longer would help the team to reach that 190 run mark, 200 run mark. Yesterday we saw the same thing with SRH. Probably they would have reached 180 or 190 run mark, and it would have been different when they come into ball.
Yep. So there are two things to it. Okay, first, yes, I truly understand what you're saying about the strike rates. You know, as I said, agar aap 10 ball mein 20 bana rahe ho, there's no use of it, right?
Exactly. Ya
to wo chase karte hue aap bana rahe ho, and you're unbeaten, and your team probably needs an 40 in the last 3, and you come in and get those 20 out of those 40, you get 20 from the 10. That makes a lot of sense. But you know, if you're 50 of Yeah, if you're opening the innings, that makes no sense. Second is, just look at the scorecard, right? If we talk about, if I can just have the scorecard, yeah. If you just talk about the score, total score, what, you just needed some 20 more or 18 more probably, and how many batsmen you have in that, proper batsmen I'm talking about, Kohli, Faf, Green, Patidar, Maxwell, Nomro, Karthik, 7 batters. Each one of them, if they would have scored 3 more to the total, that would have done the job, right? I'm just bifurcating. I'm not saying ki aisa hota. I'm just bifurcating it into what you are talking about the anchor or whatever it is, right? Now, I don't really understand the anchor concept in T20 cricket, but I really understand that a player, a batter, needs to stick around to take the game deeper and score some valuable runs. That is it. T20 franchise cricket is also about entertainment. Ya to fir trophies ki baat mat karo yaar. Simple. Don't judge a player on trophies. Oh, kitna jeeta, kya jeeta. Which a lot of experts do it, have been doing it, will do it. Rather, don't judge people on those grounds. And if you're judging, then have a proper strategy. You know, have a lineup that can give you that 190, 200 odd every, you know, in every game. And that is it. Or anchor ka definition ki zarurat nahi hai wahan pe, lekin kahin na kahin aapko ek player chahiye jo ruk ke khele, ya do player hai chahiye jo ruk ke khele. That is it. That right. How difficult it is. Ye intent main wahi bol raha hu, intent ki baat karna, har cheez mein intent kya tha. Are kya intent tha yaar, pehla ball utha ke maar ke catch out ho gaya, zero pe out ho gaya, ye intent tha.
फिर आप बोलोगे टीम हार गया, बट उसने
मैक्सवेल ने क्या किया, मैक्सवेल ने सीधा उठाया, आया उठा के सीधा हाथ में जुरेल को दे दिया. ऐसा कोई उसमें कोई बहुत बड़ा बहुत बहुत कोई फैसिनेटिंग सा कैच नहीं था, वो सीधा कैच था, रेगुलेशन कैच होता है इतने बड़े प्लेयर, इतने बड़े लेवल पे खेलने वाले प्लेयर के लिए. कर दिया ना वो, ही इज वन ऑफ द कल्प्रिट्स फॉर आरसीबी'स लॉस टुडे. दैट इज इट. यही वो 20 रन दे देता 10 बॉल में, हो जाता काम. सो या आई डोंट अंडरस्टैंड दिस एंकर दिस थिंग, बट यू नो आई डोंट इवन अंडरस्टैंड दिस इंटेंट का कॉन्सेप्ट. क्या है यार, क्या इंटेंट है? जब रन ही नहीं बन रहे तो इंटेंट का क्या करोगे, चार डालोगे?
Quite a lot on the batting side, Soumya. Let's talk about Rajasthan's bowling a bit. Trent Bolt spell, जो power play में उन्होंने किया है, is bowled at an economy of 4 in his 4 overs, and Ravi Ashwin again an economy of 4.6 or 4.8 something, also picked up a wicket. So specifically for these two bowlers, there are other bowlers. Avesh Khan picked up 3 wickets, but he was quite expensive as well. Chahal got Kohli, but he also went for 44 runs. So specifically for Bolt and Ashwin, what do you think about their spell? How important were their spells?
I guess that was a turning point for Rajasthan Royals, you know, keeping Royal Challengers to a very, you know, to a decent total, to a total that was just defendable, but also chaseable, right? You know, and that is what happened. Ek partnership laga baad mein unka, and things totally changed. So kahin na kahin wo spells jo the dono ke, wo economical spells, and I always talk about this. T20 cricket mein koi bowler wicket le raha hai nahi le raha, if he is bowling at under 5, under 6, he is a gold mine. I mean, aap usse better bowler nahi expect kar sakte, kyunki wo ek end se opposition ko choke kar raha hai, and the opposition will make mistakes. जब उनको दूसरा बॉलर जो जिसको वो मार सकते हैं उसके अगेंस्ट खेलेंगे ना, तो वो कहीं ना कहीं वो मिस्टेक्स होंगी, एंड दैट इज व्हाट हैज हैपेंड टुडे.
एंड अ वर्ड ऑन राजस्थान्स बैटिंग, दे स्टार्टेड क्वाइट स्लोली इन द फर्स्ट ओवर्स, बट देन जयसवाल इमीडिएटली पिक्ड अप फ्रॉम द थर्ड ओवर ऑनवर्ड्स, एंड द वे दे बैटेड थ्रू आउट द इनिंग्स, दे केप्ट लूजिंग विकेट्स बट डिडंट lose themselves or didn't lose hope of winning the game. They knew the target was chaseable. So what do you think about their batting lineup?
I guess, you know, batting was a decent one. As we can see, a very good contribution from Rehan Parag. That was a very crucial knock. And Shimran Hetmayer. Wo jo partnership beech mein laga na, ek chota sa jo ek partnership aaya, that was a very important one. And then the rest was done by Roman Paul. But really, really disappointed with the way Sanju Samson got out. Boss, you're going to play the World Cup in a week's time or probably in 10 days' time. I know, probably you won't be in the starting 11, but you can be needed any time, right? You know, that's how the game works. And you need to understand the importance of your wicket. Aapko, now comes the anchor role, right? Wo jo ruk ke khelna chahiye tha, संजू सैमसन का विकेट बहुत बड़ा हो गया था एक टाइम पे, एंड अगर वो छोटा सा पार्टनरशिप बीच में नहीं आता तो द मैच कुड हैव टर्न्ड इन एनी डायरेक्शन. सो कहीं ना कहीं एंड गेटिंग आउट इन दैट मैनर, यू गेटिंग स्टम्प्ड ऑन अ वाइड डिलीवरी वॉज गोइंग आउटसाइड ऑफ सम, वो प्रीमेडिटेटेड था, बॉलर ने रीड कर लिया था. वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट इट कि वी समहाउ रेड दिस, क्योंकि वो थोड़ा सा चोक किए थे पहले दो बॉल्स में, एंड ही वॉज लुकिंग अ बिट रेस्टलेस. और वो कहीं ना कहीं बहुत अच्छा एक एक जो स्पिन वेब किया था वो बहुत अच्छा था. कर्ण शर्मा, इफ आई एम नॉट मिस्टेकन, ही गॉट हिम, या ही गॉट रिड ऑफ, या सो वो एक बहुत अच्छा स्ट्रैटेजी उन्होंने लगाया था कि दो बॉल को डॉट किया, उसके बाद बाहर बुलाया, इनवाइट किया, थोड़ा टॉसअप किया, ही टर्न्ड इट अवे फ्रॉम द राइट हैंडर. सो कहीं ना कहीं वो एक बहुत अच्छा डिलीवरी था, बट अगेन यू नो यू शुड बी पेशेंट अबाउट इट. अगर आपने देख लिया आपके रीच से बाहर है तो यार उसे थोड़ा सा कवर्स की तरफ या ऑफ साइड की तरफ खेल के आप एक ईजी सिंगल निकाल सकते थे, या your experience enough to negate that. So very disappointed to see him getting that phase out, and you really need to understand, you know, that's the temperament I always talk about. That's the problem I have with a couple of more players who will be a part of that World Cup. I won't name anyone right now because wo discussion bahut bada ho jayega. So this is what temperament is all about. And I always say, boss, aapke dusri taraf ek aisa player khada hai jisne wo temperament ko hi apna weapon bana ke अनगिनत चेंजेस करे हैं. एग्जैक्टली, विराट कोहली को सिर्फ देख के सीखो यार, सिर्फ उनके वीडियोस देखो. आई एम नॉट कंपेयरिंग टू इंडिविजुअल्स, बट आई एम जस्ट टॉकिंग. मैं किसी का गेम भी कभी कंपेयर नहीं करता, बिकॉज एट दिस लेवल यू नो वी कैन जस्ट टॉक अबाउट द गेम, वी कैन जस्ट टॉक अबाउट कि क्या गलती हुई, बट जो एबिलिटी है वो एबिलिटी है, बट उसको उसको उसके ऊपर यू नो कैपिटलाइज करना वो प्लेयर का इंडिविजुअल का काम होता है. And that's what Mr. Virat Kohli has done for so many years now. I mean, people, I don't know what people talk very highly about him. His counterparts talk very highly about him. But when it comes down to, you know, do something of that sort, they fail. So, I mean, there's no learning as such, I just feel.
I think with the थिंक अबाउट टेम्परामेंट दैट यू आर टॉकिंग, सैमसन आज शुरू से ही ऐसा लग रहा था थोड़ा कि ही इज नॉट इन द परफेक्ट फ्रेम ऑफ माइंड जो एक चेस के टाइम चाहिए होता है. ही वॉज ट्राइंग टू टेल समथिंग टू जयसवाल और मे बी शॉट ऑन हिम, आई एम नॉट कम्प्लीटली श्योर, बट ही वॉज ट्राइंग टू डू दैट इन द प्रोसेस. ही कुड हैव गॉट रन आउट देयर इफ करण शर्मा वॉज एक्स्ट्रा अलर्ट, संजू सैमसन वुड हैव बीन रन आउट बिकॉज ही डिडंट इवन बॉदर टू put his bat inside the crease, but instead he turned towards Jaiswal at the other end and was trying to tell him something while taking a run. So that was very weird. The commentators also called that out on the broadcast. So I think he was not in the perfect frame of mind today, and hopefully it was only for today. As you just mentioned, agar World Cup mein jab bhi unko mauka milta hai, to aisa nahi hoga, hopefully. But before we close this down, Soumya, and because you mentioned a lot of things about Virat Kohli, a word on RCB's fielding overall, that Virat Kohli run out, that Faf du Plessis catch. Initially, do teen catches chhode RCB ne, ek do boundaries de diye miss fielding ke baad, but then the way they fielded towards the latter half of the innings, what do you think about those things?
I was waiting for this question, Bansal. I'll just open up our group news 18 group sports editor K. Srinivas Rao tweet. He summed it up very well. Okay, if I can just have that tweet. You know, he's talking about, he's explaining, you know, how the fitness thing, जिसकी बहुत ज़्यादा बात होती है, उसका क्या फायदा है? वो आज दिखा, वो जो run out हुआ, he was running towards his left side, picked up the ball, turned quickly, and you know threw it with a lot of accuracy,
right,
and got the player out. So I mean, that's it. That sums up everything probably. I mean, that's just amazing, brilliant. And then this guy's energy is so fascinating, so infectious, you know, wo different tarike ka ek mahol bana deti hai. So yeah, I mean, fantastic. And I just feel so good that he's going with that kind of a frame of mind, with that kind of a batting form, with that kind of a fielding form into the World Cup. It's going to be very, very beneficial for the Indian team.
Let us just hope that it is beneficial for the Indian team, as you just mentioned. And just one last thing, Soumya, what do you think of the next match between SRH and RR?
Yeah, next match between SRH and RR. I guess I would give it to SRH. I think they are in a better shape. They lost the previous game, but they are in a better form. I mean, that was one of those off days that they had against KKR. So yeah, I'll just read out this tweet from Srini. Okay, all the chatter we keep hearing around VK's fitness, well, this run out sums it up perfectly. He was running left, fielding deep, had to switch to the throwing arm, and more importantly, it happened when it mattered. Small things add up. So yeah, I mean, he has summed it up nicely.
Okay. Thank you, Soumya. Thanks a lot for your insights. Just to sum up the match.
Just to remind our viewers, DK's IPL captain. And so yeah.
Would you like to have a word on him as well? We've been watching him for a long, long time. What do you think about his career?
No, it's a very interesting career, so to say. You know, a very good one. Making a comeback to that World Cup, being a part of that 2007. T20 World Cup, very young at that point of time. He and Rohit were very young, and even Yusuf Pathan, Irfan, it was a young team. Uske saath saath, just jitne IPL franchises ke liye wo khele, it has been a very joyful thing to watch him while he has been on the screens, you know, keeping wickets for different franchises. He led KKR. It wasn't a great run, but again, you know, a good. I just feel he's a good leader. You know, he's been somebody who is a very intelligent cricketer. I feel he is also someone who is very intelligent cricketer. And you can when you just listen to his analysis about the game when he's not out there on the field, that is just good. So I just hope he switches puri tarah to a career, he comes as a broadcaster, because wo analysis sunne mein बहुत मजा आएगा. तो यार अ ग्रेट करियर एंड अ वेरी गुड वन, अ वेरी लॉन्ग वन. इट्स एंड द वे ही यू नो ही एडेड दोज वेपन्स टू हिज आर्मरी इन द लेटर फैग एंड ऑफ हिज आईपीएल करियर, दोज स्कूप्स एंड दोज यू नो रैम शॉट्स, वॉकिंग अक्रॉस द स्टंप्स एंड हिटिंग द फास्ट बॉलर्स टू यू नो ओवर फाइन लेग, ओवर शॉर्ट फाइन लेग. सो अ वेरी गुड, इंटरेस्टिंग, एंटरटेनिंग करियर, आई वुड से.
Yeah, exactly. I'm really interested the way his career journey has taken shape over the years. I was just going through his interview with R. Ashwin yesterday on YouTube.
Yeah.
Kutti stories with Ashwin, and he has spoken a lot many things. I think he might not be happy with just one thing. He wanted to play in the IPL at least one season for CSK, but that was not supposed to happen, largely again because of MS Dhoni, who has overshadowed his career throughout the 17 or 18 years. But again, amazing person. He started off in the middle order, opened for a while, and then finishing his career in the role of a finisher. So
one thing I'll always remember is that his stumping in against England, he got it off Michael Vaughan,
2004 who, I think yes.
2002 before. Or 2004, yeah, 2004 probably. That was a bilateral series. India had already lost two games. No, it was 2003,
right.
I guess, just before the World Cup. And we were 2-0 down. That was the final,
right,
last
right.
game.
2-0
and he got him on a wide-ish delivery, you know, grabbing one very far away from him
very
and diving towards the wickets and rattled the stumps. So it was a brilliant keeping. On display. So these are the small things you remember about a player. So a great talent, a great player, and I just wish to see him as much as I can as a broadcaster, because as I said, you know, I just love his analysis of the game.
Undoubtedly, and I'm sure we will see more of him in broadcast nowadays,
yeah,
especially after his retirement from IPL as well. For now, RCB are out of the tournament. Rajasthan Royals will move on to qualify.
As usual, they're out of the tournament.
So Rajasthan Royals will face SRH on Friday in Chennai. You stay tuned to Cricket Next. We'll bring all the updates from that game. For now, it's a goodbye from us. Stay tuned to Cricket Next.
Fastest cricket score updates. या सबसे डिटेल्ड स्टैट्स,
क्रिकेट के अंदर बाहर की खबरें,
या हेल्दी डिबेट्स,
सबसे एक्यूरेट एनालिसिस,
या फैंस का क्रेज, सबके लिए एक ही प्लेटफॉर्म, क्योंकि क्रिकेट मतलब क्रिकेट नेक्स्ट.